Hello everyone, today we will study about physical properties of water. In the last video we have seen the structure of water. Now we will see their physical properties, which actually helps in living organisms to maintain their body temperature or their sustenance. Okay, so the first one property is the high latent heat of fusion. All the living organisms contain a good amount of water in their body, and when it evaporates, it provides cooling capacity to regulate their body temperature. The high heat of fusion of water is also of significance in stabilizing the biological environment. Although cellular water rarely freezes in higher living forms, actually the heat released by water on freezing is a major factor in slowing the temperature drop of a body of water during the winter season. That's why our body do not freeze during the winter season, or the rate is very slow. Okay, then the second physical property is high heat capacity, that is also known as specific heat. All of you know that water gets heated up very slowly. The specific heat of heat capacity or of water is very high. Actually, specific heat or heat capacity is the number of calories that is required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water from 15 degrees Celsius to 16 degrees Celsius, and that number is 1 kilocalorie and is usually high. That is one, and it is usually very high. And the greater the specific heat of a substance, the less the change in temperature that results when a given amount of heat is absorbed by that substance. Thus, water is well designed for keeping the temperature of a living organism relatively constant. Then the third one physical property is the high heat of vaporization. Boiling of point of water is very high, and in order to vaporize it, again, it required a large amount of calories, and the high value is very useful in helping the living organism to keep its temperature constant, since a large amount of heat can be dissipated by vaporization of water. Okay, then the next one property is surface tension. The surface tension of water is also very high, and it is this property is very useful for plants. The movement of water through soil and plant cell is very rapid, and in plant, water rises to great heights due to capillary action. Surface tension is lowered by the substance dissolved in water. Then next one property is high boiling point. As we have already discussed it, boiling point of water is very high, that is 100 degrees Celsius, and again in order to vaporize it requires a large amount of calories. Then next one physical property is expansion on freezing. That property is very unique to water. Only water expands on solidification. That means when water converted into ice, it expands, and that's why ice is less dense than water. That's why ice floats on the surface of water. And the importance of this property for biology has long been recognized. If ice were heavier than liquid water, it would sink to the bottom of its container on freezing. That means from bottom to top. And this would mean that oceans, lakes and streams would freeze from the bottom to the top, and once they frozen would extremely difficult to melt. Okay, so organisms living at the bottom of fresh water and lakes are hence protected from freezing, because ice formation starts from top to bottom, and it forms a layer, insulating layer between the environment and the bottom of the lake. And the temperature beneath this ice layer is very, very high in comparison to outer environment. That keeps the living organisms protected, and they can live at that particular temperature, because at the outer side the temperature is very, very low. The next physical property is high dielectric constant. The ability of water to behave as a good solvent is based on its dielectric constant. Okay, the dielectric constant of water is very high, that is 80. And what is dielectric constant? Actually, it is the ability of any solvent to keep two opposite charges apart, and that capacity of water is very high. Okay, so actually in water, hydrogen is positively charged and oxygen is negatively charged. Hence, the water molecule show a tendency to orient itself and they surround the oppositely charged ions, and that process is known as hydration of ion. And like this, they increase the distance between the opposite charges. The next property of physical property of water is also known as colligative property. Actually, that depends on the substance which we dissolve in it. For example, when a molecule of solute such as sugar is dissolved in water, its physical properties, that means the property of water, are altered. The properties of dilute solutions depend on the number of solute particles in solution, and the collective effect of these solute particles give rise to colligative properties, which include osmotic pressure, elevation of boiling point, lowering of vapor pressure, and freezing point depression. When ionic solutes are dissolved in water, all these properties are affected. For example, if we add a mole of sodium chloride, which contains 2 moles of ions, sodium ions and chloride ions, the soluble ions also exert the same influence on solvent as do the individual molecule. Okay, so these are the physical properties of water, and mainly their physical properties helps the living organisms to maintain their body temperature, and many of the functions depends on the constant temperature of our body. That's why in living organism the maximum percentages of water.